Ronaldo is a better player than Lionel Messi.
Well, let me tell you, Barroso, if you say this in some quarters, you will be mobbed.
It's because the truth is bitter. Ronaldo is a better player. Messi is just shining under the glory of his teammates. If he's that good, why hasn't he left back?
That is besides the point. This boy, Messi, he's the world's best player. He will be it again and again and again.
Oh, prof, you don't use a few minutes of aptitude test to discover a child's intelligence. Ronaldo is a playmaker.
Okay, Messi is a playbreaker.
See the way this boy left Man U and came to Real Madrid and is doing excellently well. Remove Messi from the Spanish La Liga and he's finished.
Oh, Dan, you don't know anything about football.
You don't know what I think about
Man
U. I'm
telling you, you don't know
I said you are ignorant. Okay, tell me, prof. Who is the current chairman of FIFA?
Look at him. Look at him. He's the current president of FIFA. He's the one that will come and play in Division 1. In La Liga, you see what I'm saying?
President
you
of chairman, who is the
who is in fact, I give up on you as if you don't know anything about football.
Oh, you know about football. Says he knows something about football. He knows something about football. And he's coming to tell me that Messi is better than Ronaldo. Somebody that depends on the goodwill of his teammates to be able to score goals. And he says he's better than, he doesn't know anything about football. Nonsense.
Money. Who are you arguing with?
Never mind.
I shouldn't mind. And you're arguing with yourself?
I said never mind. It has nothing to do with you. It's football issues.
You got me scared there. And food is ready.
Honey, I said never mind. That includes food. Until I finish watching today's match.
You mean you're going to abandon food because of football?
But you know I don't like to be disturbed when I'm in this football mood.
Look. I do not like the attention that you give to football. I don't like it at all.
What's the matter with you? What's the matter with you, Felicia? I give 90 minutes attention to football. And when my team wins, I get 90 hours of happiness. What about you? You give me only a few minutes of happiness in this house and you want to equate it with football? Let me warn you. Give me my space. Give me my space.
You mean you're comparing what we have with that of football? You will see. Are you going now?
I told you my team is playing with our match today. And we are hosting. We are going to win.
Sifei, I don't care about your victory. But this is something else. You go out all the time to watch outside, but we have television at home. No, this is becoming too much.
Okay, see, I'm more relaxed and I enjoy the game when we are watching it together at the viewing center.
Yes, so that you can view other women alongside, right?
Oh, you're definitely not serious. Oh, if you are worrying this much, get dressed and let's go together.
See, because of so much attention you have given to this game, you've made me hate it with so much passion. You look forward to this football match with so much fanfare. How many times have you looked forward to my coming back home from the shop?
You're not a football game, Odube. Don't compare yourself with one. It's just a game.
See, all I am saying is that you should love me more. You should give me more attention as you give football. Every football night, you are always going out. How many times have you taken me out, Faye? At least to look at my face.
Look, you are more than football. Hey, Bowser.
Huh?
Yes, give me a couple of seconds. I'll be with you. Yes, I'm coming. Hey, my dear, I've got to go. Ole, 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 ole. Ah! Ole, ole, ole.
Hey. Come on. Go. Hope I'm free. Don't worry. I will soon fall in love with my own game. God, how can a man give a football game this so much attention, more than his lawfully wedded wife? I think I have to cheat. Mrs. Uzo, I don't like the way your husband is enticing my husband to go out and watch football with him.
I was going to complain the same thing to you, that your husband is the one luring my husband to the viewing center since the football season started.
Oh, but it was your husband that called my husband on the phone few minutes ago. See, Mrs. Uzo, I don't like this at all. Please, tie your husband to his television set. This habit of going to the viewing center may lead them to viewing other things.
Other things? Like what?
No, before my mouth you go here say teacher mama get winch. Good night.
Hey, happy Ilgu. Oh, yes, two-zero. 2-0 at home. Ah,
that was fantastic. I'm taking you out tomorrow.
You are going to take the footballers who are giving you this much happiness out, not me.
Ha! Dupe, Dupe, the earlier you started loving the game of football, the better for you.
Faye, the earlier you started loving me and giving me attention as you give to that football game, the better.
Oh, this one, you don't understand.
Understand what?
Oh! Yes, sir, I do. Oh. Look, can you just begin to comprehend, understand, and fathom that my team just lost 2-0 away match?
So, because of that, the federal government should declare 1 week of mourning for you.
Look, if you know what is good for you, let me be. Let me be. Huh?
I will let you be. Just make sure that you do not come snuggling close to me late at night. Look for a football to hold on to.
Let me tell you. Until my team wins, there will be no snuggling up to you or to anyone else.
I see it. I see it now. Oh, so you do have someone you snuggle close to. No wonder. No wonder Mrs. Benjamin said you men who go to viewing centers end up viewing other things aside from football.
I don't think I will sit here and watch you batter my already battered head.
Go, run to them. Go!
My dear, I think we need to do something about our husband's football fanaticism. It is getting out of hand.
I don't just understand. How can somebody have a television in the house with a decoder with full monthly subscription covering all the sports channels and yet still go to a public and noisy viewing center to watch a football match?
My husband's case is worse. Anytime his team loses, then it is coldness in the house.
Your own better. Do you know that I have to fast and pray anytime my husband's team has a match to play. Oh yes. The negligence, transfer of aggression, it's really taking a toll on me. We need to do something about it. We need to make them feel the way we are feeling. That's exactly what I planned to do. So what's
wrong? I think I rather pick the blue one.
That's Chelsea. And this one is Arsenal.
They say Chelsea fans are Agbiros and stubborn people. Yes. So let me pick the red one.
Okay. Now you're going with Arsenal while I go with Chelsea. See, Mrs. Uzo, I want us to come up with our own kind of fanatism. Please, go online and Google anything and everything you need to know about Arsenal. I'll do the same about Chelsea.
So, I am Arsenal. And you are
Chelsea. I am Chelsea.
All personal.
All blues. Some people they didn't come. So, that is good. Now, let me run along. Please, get ready. I am going to say my support. All blues.
All personal. So, wait.
Move on.
Okay.
I'm asking, can someone tell me what is this all about?
Mrs. Uzo,
yeah.
Do you know that Enyimba Football Club of Aba, they play better than Arsenal?
Oh, forget about it. Who and who is in Chelsea?
Ah, Mugbira, you
know. Around the field like drunkards.
Okay, wait. Do you know the comedian called Mr. Bean?
Oh, yeah. Who doesn't know Mr. Bean?
Fine. I want you to picture Mr. Bean together with Arsene Wenger, the coach of Arsenal.
Get it. Forget it.
They are birds of a feather, man. That man is a big joker.
It's not true.
Arsene Wenger thinks football is a joke. He's a huge joker.
Forget
just like
it.
His brother from another mother, Mr. Bean.
Come. Do you people realize I'm still standing here?
Can someone explain to me what this is all about?
Let me tell you, you know nothing about football.
Because all the people who are footballers in Chelsea, they are long gone. What you have there is ballers. Like Drogba. Left.
No, okay. Now let me tell you what you don't know, baby. Drogba might have left. Mm-hmm. What about Victor Moses? What about Mikel Obi? Nigeria!
What about old Torres?
You are at home?
Oh yes, I am relaxing.
I see. That's an old match you're watching.
Yes, sit down. Yes.
It's not a matter of sitting down, Prof. Have you seen your wife and mine?
Is there anything the matter?
Come.
Old man,
he's old.
lying. What are you talking?
It's obviously.
Okay, wait. What is the position of Asna on the table? Oh, the league is still on. Yes, and thank God we're going to make 3 points today after we beat Chelsea.
Oh, yes.
Asna beat Chelsea.
Oh, yes. For where? Now, what's still on?
Let's bet. We should bet.
Yes.
Okay, with what? Our marriages. Marriages?
Yes.
Agree. Okay. If Asna beat Chelsea, I would divorce my husband.
And if Chelsea wins Arsenal, I'll leave my husband.
Oh, Arsenal. Agree.
That's it, sir.
Dupe, don't tell me you just traded our marriage away for a football game.
Point of correction, Faye. I made a bet, not a trade.
What if you lose the bet?
Oh, then you better pray hard that my team does not lose the match.
Look, this is one huge joke gone too far. How can you bet your marriage away on an ordinary game of football?
Ah! Mugbe. Football you call ordinary. Faye, football is my life. Huh. Eh? My entire life depends on the leather game. Football gives love. Feyi, it is a game that unites the whole world together.
Is this how you show unity? By betting away your marriage?
Oh my God, Feyi. Football is everything. Don't you get it?
I don't get it, though. I mean, when did this love start for the game that you once loathed?
Trolley, up Chelsea! Blue for life! See, my love for football started the day I discovered Chelsea Club. The club that always make me go high. The club that means everything to me. In fact, as a matter of fact, Chelsea means everything. Any other thing does not matter right now. All blues for life. I beg, let me go inside and pray so that my team does not lose the match today.
This is a very serious issue, you know.
Ah, Prof, you don't understand though. My wife told me they meant that bet. They meant everything. But what baffles me is, how can you bet your marriage on Arsenal of all football clubs?
No, I thought they were joking, but it appears they want to get back at us.
The way they are carrying this on, I think we are in big pot of soup, you and I. And then especially with your wife leading the rebellion, I can see a lot of shutdown coming on soon.
What do you mean?
As a lawyer, I see marriages shutting down every day all in the name of football.
Maybe we should have carried them along.
How?
Well, by balancing the love for the game with the love for family.
But they never loved football up till now.
We should have made them love it. And when our team loses, we just hit down hard on them.
But that one is a normal, spontaneous reaction that we give when the teams lose. Okay, so how are we going to deliver them from this new demon?
Mike, my match is by 4 p.m. tomorrow and I'm not going to be around.
And where will you be going?
Of course, you don't expect us to watch the great duel between Chelsea and Arsenal at home, do you?
Where else would you be going to watch it?
Mrs. Benjamin and I are going to the viewing center.
I'm sorry, that will not be possible. We have a television set in this house, so you're not stepping out of this house under the guise of going somewhere to go and watch football match.
And why is that?
You have to understand, you are a married woman. How would people rate you if they see you at a viewing center watching a game of football all alone? Huh? It's not good for your status.
Oh, so it's good for your own status, abandoning the comfort of your home and go to a viewing center to watch a match?
You need to understand that I am a man. This is how these things happen here. When they, you know, it's
what is good for the goose is also good for the gander. Good night.
Okay. I give up. I apologize. I will no longer go to viewing centers henceforth.
That is after Mrs. Benjamin and I have gone to the viewing center to see things for ourselves.
No way. My wife will not watch a football match in a pub.
On some conditions.
Which are?
Husbands will not abandon food. No transfer of match loss aggression towards wife. Husbands will cease to go to the viewing centers. Henceforth, they will watch the matches at home.
With wives.
Deal.
Sometimes we get on each other's nerves.